bubblegum as Sleeping Beauty. Once upon a time, not too long ago, lived a king and queen in a beautiful castle. And they longed very much to have a child. So God blessed them and gave them a beautiful baby girl. So they named her Aurora, like the sparkling sunrise.
That's me. Hi, everybody.
The king and queen decided to have a beautiful party for their new baby girl. So they invited everyone in the land. And she got lots of gifts and presents from the fairies. One gave her the gift of beauty, with hair that shined like the golden sun. Another fairy, the fairy of lilacs, gave her the gift of song, so she could sing like a beautiful nightingale. The other gave her beautiful red lips that were deeper than the reddest rose. Then suddenly, in the middle of the party, boom, clash, the evil, maleficent fairy witch came in. She was very upset because she was not invited. Of course, who would want to invite somebody that was mean and cruel to hang around their daughter? But, you know, anyway. Maleficent decided she would give the child something too. A curse that on her 18th birthday, Aurora would prick her finger on a rose and die. Which is not the way to make friends at a birthday party, Maleficent. However, one of the fairies was still left. She had not given her gift yet. So she in turn, although she was not powerful enough to take away the spell, but she was able instead to change it. That on the 18th birthday, Aurora does not prick her finger and die, but instead falls asleep until her true love wakes her. Aurora grew strong and beautiful, and loved to sing to the birds and amuse her friends and family with her songs. However, on Aurora's beautiful 18th birthday, all her friends and family joined together. There was one single old lady who came up to Aurora with a gift, a single red rose. Aurora had never seen a flower like this, for she was not told of the curse or what had happened, nor has she been allowed to see or even touch a rose. With Aurora's kind-hearted gentleness, she gladly accepted the rose from the little lady and accidentally pricked her fingers and fell dizzy, fast asleep. The lady transformed into Maleficent and vanished. Her family, sad and grieved, rushed to her side to carry the beautiful princess and put her on a bed of flowers until her true love came and waked her. But in a moment, something strange happened. The beautiful color of Aurora's lips seemed to shine bright as ever, and her skin beautiful and bright, full of life, and she awoke. Everyone was amazed. Aurora did not need a kiss from a prince to come and save her. Her heart was already full of love, for she loved everyone, her family, her friends, her beautiful cat, the birds that she sang to on the windowsill. Prince Philip was most happy and so glad to have his princess back. So of course, Aurora and Prince Philip danced the night away with their friends. And they all lived happily ever after.